have to be stronger than this. The time for mercy is over.
Get ready. It's coming. Say the same for people who don't share his taste in music. Maybe we can work on this whole trust thing after all. Got more work for you back at the Wolf's Den if you're looking to keep busy. See you around.
He's gone. We're coming for you, Sinner!
I think they're all gone.
tell just from looking at you that you're no Peggy. If you were, we'd be having different words. Glad you joined the right side. Call me Bo. I've been living off this land for as long as I can remember. I've seen a lot over the years. Crime, corruption, madness. But nothing like Eden's Gate. It hasn't changed my ways, though. Just another thing to survive against. Ain't nothing more powerful than Mother Nature. But you don't beat her. You work with her. Now, in times like these, it ain't smart relying on man-made junk to save your ass. I can see the skepticism in your eyes. Tell you what, give me some eagle feathers and big old leviathan bones, and I'll prove it to you.
Our scouts have found a plane at the Lansdowne airfield. Now all we need to do is slip past Jacob's patrols and go get it. What do you say? You sure?
saving my hide.
There's a lot more of them out there, Depp. If you come across any others, you rescue them, too. Don't let those goddamn Peggies take any more good folk.
There's an airstrip nearby with planes and everything. I go there myself, but Jacob's always got men watching it.
That Wolfston has eyes on the whole damn forest.
Harder to hide with the sun out. That just adds to the challenge.
Hellfire.
Got a job for you.
You remember the Grand View Hotel? That shithole we pulled you out of?
Honey?
Need you to head back there. Jacob nabbed a whitetail by the name of Briggs, and he's using the same brain-melting nonsense he tried on you. All in the hopes that Briggs will give up the wolf's den. I don't think our boy can hold out as long as you did. And if he gives up our location, we're done. So we gotta move on this quick. Some folks here think the smart move would be just to off him. But if we start killing our own to save our asses, how's that make us any better than Jacob? Nah, I ain't going down that road. Here's what we're gonna do instead. Weedy's cooked up a little deprogramming package. Same thing we used on you. Need you to swap out the tape they got running in Briggs' room with the one I'm gonna give you. And then, well, then we'll see what happens. If everything goes smooth, our guy comes back to Earth. If it doesn't, well, we'll deal with that when the time comes.
Maverick here. If you explosions down,
honey, this is gonna last. Wasn't sure you'd come back, but I guess you're full of surprises. This squealer here ran security up at the chalet. Lucky for us, he wasn't that good at his job and wound up in my kiddie pool. Seems the place is being used as a training ground for the Chosen. If you've seen them in action, you know how ruthless they are. You know what Jacob taught him to use for target practice? Live bodies. Gets their first kill jitters out of the way. These motherfuckers don't value any life that ain't in their cult. And they need to be put down like the dogs they are. So you're gonna head up to that chalet. You're gonna kill every Chosen you see, and you're gonna rig that building with explosives. And then we're gonna watch that whole fucking place turn into a smoldering heap of ash. Sound good to you?
One of them sonic beacons. They use those things to lure the wolves in so they can trap them. See what you can do to take the rest of them out.
you on the cameras. The stash should be somewhere. Shit. There's a cult patrol headed your way. Better hurry.
Okay, kid. Eli here. Got you on the cameras. Grandview's a straight shot north of there. Get moving.
Definitely be outside the cabin. Take a look around. Still no luck? It could be some sort of bug-out hole nearby. You know, like a small hatch. Got it? Nice job. On to the next one.
Showed up when you did. My whole team was taken and strung up for these monsters to train on. It was just luck that I wasn't taken too. Fuck, I mean, I've been studying these judges for months now. It's, well, to put it bluntly, pretty weird shit. Essentially, Jacob and his soldiers have been pumping these poor wolves full of some kind of drug. No idea what it is, but it's turning them into war machines. What's worse is the cult seems to be able to control these animals. It sounds crazy, I know, but I've seen the judges follow human commands. The scariest part of all this is that I don't think they're limiting these experiments to just wolves.
Life was simple and harsh. basic survival. That's when we were at our best.
Get that mouse right away from me!
Look at that! I'll take
care of it!
Someone's putting it to the Peggy's. Guessing that was you.
I'd like to see the Peggy's even.
Pretty sure I heard someone screaming over from Frank's place there. We should go and make sure he's okay.
Assholes messed everything
up.
Hey,
thanks.
Wanna try your luck? I got the targets all set up. The record for shooting them all is 30 seconds. Let's see if you can do any better.
We'll get these weapons back to the wolves. Fun to use on some Peggy's.
Keep it up. Peggy's ain't gonna see the white tails coming. Peggy's were up to some twisted shit here.
Come on.
One of you will be strong.
Not again.
Yeah, you're peaches.
I know you're in pain. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh, huh? You're not the only one to be tested. Did you know that I had a wife? So beautiful, isn't she? We were pregnant with our first child. And we were just babies ourselves, really. And I was terrified of becoming a father, mostly about money. She wasn't worried. She had faith that things were gonna work out. She always had faith. And one day she was gonna go visit a friend. There was an accident. The Lord take it. They rushed me to a hospital and put me in a room with this little pink bundle stuffed with tubes. And they said that I had to be strong because my little girl was gonna live. God was looking out for our daughter. And they left me alone in the room with her. I just stared at my daughter. So helpless, so innocent. And all she had in the world was me. A nobody from nowhere with nothing. And in that moment, I knew that God was testing me. He was laying out a path before me, and all I had to do was choose. So I put my hand on my little girl's head, and I leaned in and I could smell. And we prayed together, prayed for wisdom, prayed for strength. Plan for me. I took my fingers and I put them on that little plastic tube that was taped to her angelic face, and I pinched it shut. And after a little while, her legs began to kick in and kick in. And then nothing. Stillness. Release. The Lord giveth, and the Lord taketh. Pain, sacrifice, these are all part of His test. And we have to prove that we can serve God, no matter what He asks.
Good. Call the herd. Keep moving.
sacrifice the weak.
You're no hero! Make your sacrifice!
Good. Not bad.
Could really use your help out there. Pop by the wolf stand if you get the chance. We got a lot of work to do. Thank you.
Did you see that plane crash into the mountain? Someone should get up there before the Peggies do. Who knows what they'll find?
Stay safe, Deputy.
Judges.
fishing brings a body peace like nothing else. And don't we ever need peace in times like these? You'd be a fool not to take advantage of the fishing round these parts. Having a moment just to yourself in all this craziness? Well, it's good for the soul. It's important not to lose sight of what is and isn't worth fighting for. Way I see it, the biggest problem these days all stem from the fact that most people don't stop and think before they act. Not every problem is solved with a bullet, you know. Anyway, that's just my two cents. If you need any gear or bait or the like, I can set you up. Peggy's are like a terrible wildfire. Everything they touch dies.
Eyes open. There's choppers in the area. This place is a goddamn fortress.
Ancient men were killers. They were tenacious. They were strong. Now what are we? Passive, lazy, weak. Culture and technology hasn't improved us. It's brought us to our knees. If our ancestors could see us now, they would be ashamed. They would be sickened, and they would be angry.
There's been trouble here!
What do we do?
We have forgotten where we came from. We have forgotten who we are.
Don't! technology.
Looks like he got him. Set the charges and finish this with fire.